In 2019, the total revenue of cloud computing reached over $100 billion. Cloud is becoming ubiquitous as a part of any technology infrastructure, and the numbers are showing this trend very clearly. This time on the show, Microsoft Azure turns 10, woo, and we celebrate with virtual cake. Hyperledger, blockchain, and Kubernetes meet in an unholy union, and some welcome updates to Azure API Management. You're watching Azure This Week, the show that always finds a way to satisfy the sweet tooth of the host. Cake. This week, Azure turned 10 with the public launch on the 1st of February 2010. We have been able to enjoy Microsoft flavored cloud Kool-Aid for a decade. Starting out in life as Windows Azure, the original offering was launched in 21 countries and had a handful of products on offer. Today, Azure is in 56 regions with dedicated data centers and serves millions of customers with over 600 services. While AWS is still the largest cloud computing provider, the growth of Azure is an astounding 63.9% in 2019. Azure now holds a 16.9% market share compared to AWS's 32.3%. The gap is decreasing and 2020 will be another huge year for Microsoft Azure. 2018 was the year where every manager wanted to harness the power of blockchain, and 2019 was when companies realized what the technology is and actually does. 2020 will likely see a lot more blockchain services integrated with cloud products to offer advantages of the technology. And another delicious buzzword is Kubernetes, a container orchestration tool that is quickly becoming the de facto standard for managing your containerized applications and infrastructure. Putting the two together has to be amazing. Hyperledger Fabric is a blockchain implementation that has all the right buzzwords. Decentralized chain code features, private data enhancements, and improve performance, just to name a few. More importantly, there is a new Azure Marketplace template to use Hyperledger Fabric with Azure Kubernetes services. As Microsoft puts it, the modular template allows you to customize scenarios and applications quickly without spending time building out the infrastructure. Configure the VM series, number of nodes, fault tolerance, and more through the template's input parameters. And if you want to be up to speed with Kubernetes, check out our monthly show with Nigel Poulton. He is delightfully British. I just offended all the British. This week, a couple of updates reached general availability for Azure API Management. OpenAPI v3 support includes fixes and improvements such as support for multipart or form data and interoperability between OpenAPI versions. OpenAPI is an industry standard for API design. Azure API Management now also supports integration with Azure App Services, specifically API apps. You can use the advanced features of API Management to expose APIs hosted on App Services using the built-in service extension. As we say on the AirCloud Guru team, when we have to merge two teams of talent while still producing great content, seek and you shall cloud. See you next week for a special episode of the show, and keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.